This might actually be mild brainwashing, but if it works, it doesn't matter. So your relationships with other people, right? You've got a couple of friends. You've got a couple of friends, and that's not a problem, because it makes sense. Like, you in your own head know why that's happened rationally. It just requires a little extra bit of thought to explain. So, explaining basically, you have always been different, like, there's no denying it. And fitting into a group is something which has both been difficult for you because of how you look and not being conventional, but also because of how your mind kind of started thinking, probably post-puberty and with everything going on in your house. It's fair to say, like, social anxiety is a thing, but also the quality of the friends that you have is pretty cool. Like, they're pretty cool people, and you can have pretty real chats with them. And when you're good, you can be a really good friend to them. Now, I think that part of the problem is that you feel like you're acting when you're with them, and you're having negative thoughts in your mind at the same time. And those negative thoughts are normally about feeling discomfort, having cravings, this kind of stuff. Now, I think if you have enough questions to ask them and enough topics of conversation, then you can enjoy the process of being with them, and you can try and create an art of conversation without allowing the combination to fall down these familiar rabbit holes, which can be quite draining. I was just thinking, I mean, don't know whether to make this private or public. Don't really want to force myself too much, but at the same time, can probably find ways to say this in a. You know what? I'm gonna record this video, and it's about the two Zoes and Jess, and I'm gonna send it to them, and I'm gonna ask them whether they mind me keeping it public. And if not, every time I reference them, I'll make it private. But they are the three people that I've been seeing in this time of lockdown, predominantly, and all I've been able to speak to them about pretty much, apart from on the spontaneous moment of good day, is how shit I feel and not knowing what to do. And we've been looking for, like, things for me to do, and it's become very, like, my whole reality has become very warped fit to only be able to think about me. And not only does that bother me because I can see how it affects them, it bothers me because I feel trapped there. I feel like I can't speak about anything else. It almost makes the relationship like a relationship of exchange and use as opposed to a genuine care. And then I don't even know, like, where my feelings are coming from and why I'm doing what. So, what other things are there to talk about other than the self, and how can I steer conversations away from myself, and talk about other things? Because actually, like, the joy of being with people that you love or that you care about is the company and is the spending time together. It's not always to pick each other up, and actually, very rarely do they have the answers for you, or do you have the answers for them. It's like sometimes you need to let off steam, but a lot of the time it doesn't help. Especially like, one of the universal commonalities that we talk about is, like, you've been talking about this for that long, and that's basically them saying, like, there's nothing more I can do. Like, it's there is no point to the intention of saying it out loud. And also creating environments where you feel comfortable hanging out. Like, it's okay. Like, you are a bit pedantic and specific and whatever. And if, like, for now, you need to be that way, for example, not wanting to go for a picnic, wanting to go for a walk instead or whatever, that's cool. That, like, don't worry about that part so much as the actual topic of conversation being discussed when you're there, and, like, the relating part of the relationship, I suppose. The trouble is, I don't have any questions. And when I've looked on Google at like things that you can talk to people about that aren't yourself, stuff that comes up is like really boring stuff. And I also do want to just like be able to go with the flow. I want to be able to just go with the flow of conversation, but I just noticed, like, maybe this is just also good because I can just say, like, it's a way of saying, like, I can notice when we fall down a rabbit hole of me. And I think the only thing that needs to be said in that moment, and I can probably start to say this, is like, this problem is not going to get solved today. I will more likely have a more coherent conversation with myself about it when I get home. Either, most of the time, what I'll really want is a hug or like physical affection, which I know with Corona is controversial, but like, actually, like if I'm wanting comfort, then that's like, that's much better because that's just comfort. Or to change the, to just change it and to recognize that changing a conversation and moving away from something which feels so all-consuming is empowering. Because yeah, we can't fix problems in a day. Yeah, like, you know, one of the thoughts I've had is just how scary it is that like there really isn't anyone who can help me, like there isn't anyone who can just take this away and like make me confident that I am not gonna be the reason for my downfall. Like if something external happens, I can't control that, but it's not gonna be me. Like no one else can make me confident in that. But that's okay. That is okay. And the importance of continuing to see your friends is that they do help recalibrate you, I think, with reality. And a reality that I think you do want to be a part of. Like, you do, because you get lonely and you check your phone for Instagram and all that kind of stuff. Like, I can see where my thinking lacks clarity, and maybe with hindsight I will be able to see this kind of stuff better, but I'm just trying. Like, I'm just trying to address it and to attack it. And it's funny that when I'm with my family I'm thinking about my friends, but it's just what came to my head, so I thought I'd talk about it. So let's try and take something away from this. And also, I am sharing it with them if they have 10 minutes or whatever and they feel like just putting it on while they go for a walk or whatever, cool. And constructive criticism are more beneficial ways to communicate. Please throw them my way as well. But this is just an idea and a way of communicating. And to those three in terms of questions, I think I have to think about it some more, but there's obviously like all of the stuff to do with the future and then like stories from the past, and memories, like you can always ask about like memories and stuff like that. But my mind just goes to like negative things, like what are your biggest fears, and I've asked them all this stuff before. I mean, maybe there's another option as well, maybe it's not just about questions. Like Zoe Tara said, you know, doing activities is good as well, doing stuff together. But I think that the most important part is that I have to be on a certain wave to actually be able to see my friends, and even if I'm not, to an extent, they get me there. And I'd like to try and stay on form, in a sense, even when I'm not with other people. So it's not like there's just this massive contrast in me between me on my own and me with people. And I think that works both ways. I'd like to be able to feel comfortable, like completely breaking down on my own, if that's what has to happen, getting on my hands and knees and begging for something. And I'd also like to be able to be okay on my own. And as long as I'm kind of saying to you three, that whoever shows up whether it's like the strong, protector, enthusiastic Fee, whether I'm on my knees feeling completely helpless, like I'm going to be living in my mom's house until I'm 40 and not do anything, or anywhere in between, like I'm not your responsibility, and I, you know, you three are always in my mind, in different ways at different times, and yeah, I care about you a lot, and I really am looking to feel like a positive contributor towards those relationships. And while I recognise that everything has an intention behind it, and even me posting this and me sharing it with you shows an intention of an action, it is a gesture of love and an attempt to work on relationships in a time of really like a lot of unpredictability. So yeah, love you guys, and that is all.